61 degrees at 1045.
Guess what? Mill Knot. Brand new label and a new low price. Mill Knot. That's what. Mill Knot.
The Howard Miller Show. Now here with Music on Records is Howard Miller.
Thank you very much, Joe Foss. And once again, from the Middle West to all of you all over these United States, we are speaking from a vantage point which is going to be connected in just a moment or two with a great pal of ours in the record industry and in the show world, a fellow by the name of Dean Martin, who, of course, accomplished not only quite a few gold-selling records for himself by virtue of the fact that they sold well over a million, but has carved out an enviable niche for himself in the world of show business, having just concluded a most triumphal return to Las Vegas, where he worked the Sands, and now right on the eve of his opening in the Mouli Rouge in California. Well, we roused Mr. Dean Martin early today so that we could get him on these long-distance lines set up by CBS and talk to him from his home in what I hope is sunny California. Is it sunny out there, Dean?
It certainly is. Very sunny today.
It always is. Dean, I have
not
to start
out. Always.
Well, I was going to give you the opportunity of representing the Chamber of Commerce. I've got to first off start by congratulating you on that wonderful performance out at the Sands in Vegas. This must have been a truly exciting time for you, wasn't it?
It was very exciting for me, my first time out, and everybody loved it.
Who built the act for you, Dean? Is this your own creation?
Yeah, I did it all by myself.
Well, now, I didn't have an opportunity because of my work schedule to get out there and pay homage to you, and I wanted to. What sort of act are you doing? What are you including in the act?
Oh, I do about 50 minutes. I sing about 16 songs with a little patter in between all of them. I do a little soft shoe dance.
Uh-huh. You don't stick strictly to your record hits, do you, Dean, when you work an engagement of this sort?
Oh, no. I only sang two of my own records.
I presume one of them was probably That's Amore.
It sure was, and the other one was Memories Are Made of This.
Yes. Both of those records, of course, won for you the coveted Gold Record Award, Dean. How many did That's Amore go? Do you recall offhand?
Well, that's about 2.5 million, and Memories is almost a 3 million.
Oh, that's a bigger record then than That's Amore.
Yeah, it sure was.
I was under the impression that Amore was a little bit bigger. Dean, about a month ago, when a very good friend of yours and a good friend of ours now, a fellow by the name of Joe Pasternak, was out this way, he was on the show, on the Wrigley Gum Show, and he told us that he saw in you, in his production of 10,000 Bedrooms, a very serious side and a great potential as a dramatic actor. Will you take it from there and tell me how you feel about your acting career?
Well, I hope Joe is right. I'd like to do some dramatic parts, do a couple pictures without saying, although I like to stick about 60 or 65% to just light comedy.
Yes.
Know?
Well, of course, you have a great flair for comedy, but I wonder if there is much difference, really, between great comedy and great dramatic tragedy. Don't the great thespians of our time say that there is a thin line of demarcation?
Well, I've always argued that point. I don't know. I don't think he has to be... go through tragedy to be such a great comedian.
Nor do you have to go through comedy to be tragic.
Well, I don't think so. I think if you're a comedian, you just got to be happy all the time. And if you want to do it dramatic, you just do a little heavy drama. That's
yes.
All.
Well, now, your picture, 10,000 Bedrooms, was shot in Italy. What is the occasion? I'm right in saying that, am I not, Dean?
Well, yes, 4 weeks of it was shot in Italy.
Uh-huh. What is the reason that so many of these Hollywood motion pictures are being made in other countries? Is it a tax situation, a financial structure that they set up?
Well, that, and also they get such a scenic view, so beautiful, they want to get the right aspects of the picture. You get the right background.
Yes, but doesn't Hollywood have a technique so well established now that they can shoot all of that stuff there, and then bring it back, and you superimpose you over that?
Well, that was done here a long time ago, but it's more authentic because the people now know when there's just a background or not. You know what? They know when you're actually there.
I mean, you can't fool the public too much of the time.
No, you can't.
Well, how does it affect a performer like you, Dean, if you do make a picture there? Or is all of your earnings, your income, still subject to all of the taxes here, or is there some tax leniency when these pictures are shot elsewhere?
Well, that all depends on the deal you make. If you make the deal percentage, it's your taxation is a little different, but if you get just a flat sum, you'll get it right here before you even go go to the different parts of the country where he's going to make the picture.
So what you need is a real good agent who knows how to play around just a little bit so the uncle doesn't get all of it, huh?
You're sure right.
Now, Dean, we were mentioning the fact that you open, is it tonight or tomorrow night at the Mouli Rouge?
Friday night at the Mouli Rouge.
Tomorrow night. And this, of course, is going to be your second time as a single and will also probably mean a great opening there. And for how long an extended period?
Well, it's for 12 days, and they've been sold out now for 9 whole days. And tomorrow's quite a big opening. All the black tie and all my friends are going to be sitting ringside.
I'm sure that they will be.
And I hope they enjoy it.
Dean, what is your intention now as to a work schedule in the course of the years to come? Would you be content to do, say, one motion picture or two, and then...
Well, right after the Mouli Rouge, I'm going to be in New York May 25th and 26th to do the City of Hope telethon for about 20 hours to raise $1 million. We already have 400,000 pledged. And from there, I go to Pittsburgh, which is only 40 miles from my town, which is Steubenville. I work there for 8 days, then I come back and do a Western picture with Doris Day at MGM. After that, I do my own TV show, which is in September, and which will be out here. Then I go back to Vegas, August, for 3 weeks.
Sounds to me like you're lazy. You're certainly going to be one of the busiest men in the next 6 to 9 months. I think that there will be abounding these talented shores of our Dean. Let's give a salute to you and to your opening at the Mouli Rouge. And for the few remaining days that you're not sold out there, I'm going to urge all of my friends on the West Coast to pay homage to a great performer and be there to help you celebrate a real triumphal return to the West Coast of acting. Let's listen to Dean Martin, and here is his Capitol record. From the motion picture 10,000 Bedrooms, Only Trust Your Heart.
The stars may deceive you, may vanish and leave you. Be smart, only trust your heart. The breeze softly sighs, in truth may be lying. Be smart. Only trust your heart. The warmth of her kisses may teach you what bliss is, but this is a faithless lover's heart. Only trust your heart, not the far light that comes from the starlight. Be smart, only trust your heart. This is a faithless lover's art. Only trust your heart, not the far light that comes from the starlight. Be smart. Only trust your heart.
Dean Martin in a beautiful Capitol record, Only Trust Your Heart. Dean, my very best wishes, sincerely so, to a great performer and a great guy. Congratulations, and we hope to see you real soon.
Well, thank you very much, Howard, and thank you for asking me to be on your show.
Nice having you. Say hello to that charming wife of yours and the family, and we'll see you here when you come to Chicago real soon.
Well, all right.
Right, Dean. Thanks a lot. Bye. That was Dean Martin speaking to you from his home.